Here we are in the, as you can see, the Roma Termini station. This is our first train trip in Italy. I'm with Bill and M, the world travelers. And this is your first Italian train travel, right?
Ciao.
It wasn't that easy, was it?
Got to have strong.
Would have been a lot harder without Ginevra.
We didn't know where to go. We didn't know if we were on the right train. And somehow, providentially.
What I learned is one piece of luggage. One. Small.
This is how our second cousins looked 20 years ago when Dad and I visited. That's Carlo, Silvana, and Franco Di Toro. And this was the Bar Sport as it was 20 years ago. That's Bar Sport and Gelateria, ice cream shop.
Siamo nel Bar Sport.
Sì, nel Bar Sport.
Il Bar Sport. Ecco, ecco i fratelli di Toro, ecco i fratelli di Toro, ecco, ecco Carlo, e Franco, Franco, ecco Emily.
Ecco Emily, ecco. For the people back home, Nicola, say in inglese.
Bene,
send this to my friends.
E Bill.
Ecco il punch, il punch.
Beviamo il punch abruzzese. E questo è il bar.
From left to right, that's Tonino Di Toro, his wife Oliva, and of course Silvana with Dad. Tonino is now deceased. At the time, 20 years ago, he ran the bar. And now, as you saw, it's run by his sons. Oliva lives over the bar with Silvana and Carlo. This is Silvana today. Here are Franco and his wife Rosa with their two sons, Mario and Antonio. Bill and Emma are in the background there. Mario is wearing a grembiule, a little smock that all the elementary school kids wear every day. I had just shown them a video I had made the previous summer. And so this was to be the second production as far as they were concerned. At one point I asked them all to speak.
Parlate, per piacere.
Dobbiamo parlare.
As you can see, Franco has quite a card. He'd have done well with 8mm film.
Tornate presto a
trovarci. Ci manca uno.
I'll move over to the Ceramelli's. This is Gino Ceramelli's copper shop as it looked 20 years ago when Dad and I visited. Bill and Em and I visited this past October. It's now run by his daughter, Pina, who appears in the next little bit of video.
I was in that one. I was just in that one.
In what one? Movie?
No.
You've been in any of them.
We didn't see Gino. He was upstairs recovering from a heart attack he had a couple of weeks earlier. But that's his younger brother, Pierino. And the woman in the sweater is Pierino's wife, Teresa. And there's Gino's daughter, Pina, who is explaining to me that the woman standing up is her aunt on her mother's side.
Grazie. Mm-hmm.
Se parla sul posto.
Franco di Toro wanted to show us the gate of San Nicola, so he took this picture of me and Bill standing at the gate. You'll also see a plaque describing the Porta San Nicola. This is the Church of San Marco, where Dad was baptized. Franco and his family live in the neighborhood of San Marco. That's the cross of St. Mark. And then we just pan out. So 20 years ago.
Io con il pulmino della scuola.
This was here not 20 years ago.
Sure, it was here because but 20 years ago, and I'm talking too loud for this machine.
Nick, io con il pulmino della scuola vado proprio dove stanno quelle case lì.
Sì.
Ah sì.
So they had to go when she went to school. They had to go way up there.
Hey, sweetheart.
Ciao.
Ciao. Bill. This ends our little tour of Agnone. The next morning, Franco and Rosa drove us to the train station in Isernia.
We're leaving Isernia for Rome. The train is almost here. And
except for us, no one else knows what you're saying.
I know.
Taking these from back home where everyone will know what he's saying.
Yeah, I
remarked that we have sun, and Franco is so great. He was saying, no, that's not the sun. That's the light shining off the face of Emily and
we have some new folks.
Rosa and Paola.
We have some new folks, cousins of Rosa. And of course, okay. Grazie. The second leg of our journey. So you guys have seen Agnone, huh? What do you think?
We need to spend more time here, lots more time.
Yeah, how much time?
A week.
That might be difficult though.
Yeah.
Right?
Why?
Well, because you couldn't impose on them for a week.
No, you stay in a hotel.
Yeah, but they didn't like that.
Well, you have to tell them.
A week is different than one night.
One night is
okay.
Is easy.
So we're on the train to Rome, and then we get another train, and I think I'm talking too loud, and then we're going to go to Perugia.
Appassionato di skateboard.
Sì?
Mio figlio Leonardo. E a Roma c'è una manifestazione mondiale di skateboard. Oggi è andato a Roma con il treno.
Povero ragazzo.
Poverino.
L'hai mandato a Roma con il treno.
We were met at the Perugia train station by our second cousins Michele and his sister Antonietta and her son Lorenzo, and taken to this restaurant near Perugia for lunch. From there, Michele took us on to the airport, which had the only open car rental agency on that Saturday afternoon. Antonietta is explaining that her other son, Leonardo, got lost in the big Rome train station. And Michele then explains that he's not bothered when he travels to English and French-speaking countries because he only runs into fellow Italians.
Sono stato dappertutto quasi e non ho mai avuto difficoltà.
Sì.
Ho sempre incontrato italiani.
Gli italiani sono dappertutto.
So, Dopo mangiamo, andiamo all'aeroporto. Ok, bye bye. Bye bye.
We returned to Perugia 6 days later to do some touring. It's quite an interesting city. And some eating. Part of our tour included a visit to the Perugina chocolate factory. Michele is a union executive and has the factory as one of his accounts. This is the world's largest bocce. We toured a little bit at night, and later the family hosted us at a dinner. These are the three siblings, Antonietta, Michele, and their older sister, Marinetta. These are their parents. This their father, Mario. He's deceased. Their mother, Laura. And this is a picture that was taken recently of the four of them with their mother. The younger brother is Giovanni. He lives with his mother near Rome. It's Michele at the dinner. And this is Michele's family. This is his companion, Evelina, and their younger daughter, Elisa. This is their older daughter, Erika. There's Elisa. And Matteo, Erika's son. Marinetta. Marinetta lives in Gubbio. Antonietta. And Antonietta's family. Again, there's Lorenzo. And her husband, Evandro Calabresi. And here's the group of us. I hope you enjoyed this little tour of our second cousins in Agnone and Perugia. And I hope you all one day get a chance to go over yourselves. Happy New Year, and bye-bye from Minnesota.